Hello YouTube. Today I want to tell you about a very interesting and still classified incident that took place in Russia in 1961, a very important year. And I'll come back to it in my other videos too, because more than one event took place in 1961. This case, which was also reported by top Russian UFO researchers and former military men Vladimir Azhaja and German Kolchin. This case had to do with the defensive capabilities of the system protecting Moscow, the so-called anti-missile shield. And this had to do with a guided rocket that was set ablaze and destroyed by a gigantic UFO. It took place in the summer of 1961 over the town of Rybinsk, about 150 kilometers away from Moscow. The missile was part of the new defensive system which was placed around the city of Moscow. According to military observers, a gigantic disc-like UFO appeared about 20 kilometers at the altitude, together with several smaller size UFOs. So the Soviets launched missiles at them, at the UFOs. All of the rockets blew up, not even reaching 3 kilometers before the target, but before the rockets had a chance to be launched, so to say, smaller UFOs neutralized the electronic systems of the control and guidance. And control was restored after the smaller UFOs had departed. This is a very interesting case. And Soviet ufologists mentioned that it reminds them of an American case when the rocket or missile Atlas was destroyed by a UFO that appeared from nowhere. So the bottom line is the information is very scant and it's still a classified case. But let's look what's going on around Moscow. Well, apparently they placed another system the same year to protect the city, because from my research I believe that the Soviets knew they would be visited by UFOs or aliens, or call it whatever you want, that year. Now, today in the Moscow region, in the town of Safrino, there is a continuous monitoring of the sky over Moscow. It is here, as nowhere else in Russia, that they monitor what is happening right now in the sky and beyond, in outer space. The huge Dawn 2N radar, resembling a pyramid and being basically the eyes of the Moscow anti-missile defense system, keeps control every second. This is very interesting. It's like the umbrella over the city, and it harbors the capital of Russia from the rocket of enemies or adversaries. And some information was presented in the media about it. It's a truly huge radar station. It's about 35 meters high, which, by the way, it has no analogs or anything comparable in the world. And those who serve here call it the eighth wonder of the world. Just think about the numbers. During its construction, more than 30,000 tons of metal, 50,000 tons of concrete, and 20,000 kilometers of cable, several hundred kilometers of water pipes were used because they were needed for the cooling. Anyway, it is literally crammed with various top secrets. Secret systems that provide for the detection of ballistic targets, their support, selection, measurement of coordinates, and targeting anti-missiles on them. Incredibly, Dawn can simultaneously monitor more than 100 complex space objects. This is provided by a computer complex and special computing systems with a capacity of over a billion operations per second. And despite the fact that the process of protecting the Russian capital from a potential adversary is fully automated, when intercontinental ballistic missiles approach the decision, only minutes are allowed to make the decision, and only a technician is capable of doing this decision, so to say, in the system. Looking at this radar gigantic size, it is hard to understand how such a large object can be controlled. However, those who every day take charge of the dawn on duty do not see anything supernatural in their service. They point out that the fact that today Russia has the best missile defense system in the world is not only their achievement, but also of those who created and made it operational. How this was achieved by the military together with the industry in those days when the USSR existed still remains a mystery to many. The interception at an altitude of 25 kilometers of a ballistic missile flying at a speed of more than 3 kilometers per second, which was carried out for the first time in history by the USSR on March 4, 1961, was only 20 years later repeated by American experts. So March 4, 1961, they already used the system. Now, the unique capabilities of the Russian missile defense system were clearly demonstrated in February 1994 during the work in one of the joint experiments with the United States. I underline joint experiments. Watch my videos. I'm trying to tell you something. Anyway, Colonel Ilgar Tagiev's goal was to test the possibilities for detecting small space objects and tracing the so-called space debris. This Colonel Ilgar Tagiev, who has already become a legend in Russia, now heads the Department of Combat Algorithm and Programs, a very unique outfit. In the course of this experiment, special microsatellites, six metal spheres with a diameter of 5, 10, and 15 centimeters, were removed from the American Discovery spacecraft into open space. The 15-centimeter spheres were found by all the radars involved in the experiment. Objects with a diameter of 10 centimeters saw only three, two Russian and one American. That's who registered them. Now, the Dawn-2N radar, the only radar used in the world at the distance of 15 to 2,000 kilometers, was able to detect and build trajectories of two of the smallest space objects, both with a diameter of 5 centimeters. More than 200 servicemen take over the 24-hour combat duty on the missile defense of the protected area. Every day they serve there. Now, today, this system is the only missile defense system in place that ensures the guaranteed protection of Moscow and the central industrial region against strikes of all existing types of the adversary's medium and intercontinental ballistic missiles with split warheads. So you understand that whatever happens in Rybinsk, in that town, in the summer of 1961, cannot be repeated now, apparently because of this system that protects Moscow. Ilgar Tagiev can fascinatingly tell for hours without giving away, of course, that is not necessary to know about to others, about the possibilities of the invisible umbrella, which covers the capital. That is why this candidate of technical sciences, who has been entrusted with such a complex and knowledge-intensive direction, so he's a favorite source of information from journalists. And listen to this. Sometimes they ask questions about both the missile defense system and the topics that are very abstract. For example, among the popular ones about UFOs or the Chelyabinsk meteorite. Did the military personnel of the anti-missile defense compound managed to observe this phenomena. And Colonel Ilgar Tagiev says, we are not meant for these purposes. Now, this is a familiar response from the military all over the world. And with all due respect to the person who has served in the department of this combat algorithm and program since 1988, I tend to disagree. There was a purpose to building this missile defense system around Moscow, and I think this knowledge is not limited only to Moscow, and as they had done experiments with the Americans in outer space, they continue to do so, because UFOs have been sighted in the area very frequently, for example, in late 1980s, sometimes after that, and the Russians, just like the Americans, understand what is out there. They may not know all the details, and of course, we know very few details about the knowledge about the aliens and so-called UFOs that the Russian military and the American military and the Chinese military possess. But we'll continue research. Thank you for your support. If you can support me in other ways, please look up my Patreon link. It's in the description for this video. And I hope to bring you more interesting videos in the future. Thank you.